same bucks I saw earlier. They just came back out with those and fawns. I had bumped some off the trail here earlier. Brandon's over there just to my right. He's looking at 6 or 7 does, he says, too. In the morning tomorrow, we're probably going to get in tight to bedding. But tomorrow evening, I think we're going to be on the field edge here somewhere. There's just so many deer coming out here.
Oh, man, here we go.
Yo, what's up, camp?
Not much. Show you the load. We got her filled up.
Deer carts.
Packs, bows.
Oh, yeah. We're ready to go.
We are ready.
Let's load it up.
You ready for this, Brandon?
Oh, yeah. Fired up.
A long time coming.
All right. Shoot a couple arrows before we leave?
Yeah, I want to send a couple. Yep, just for...
Last couple.
Yep, just for sanity's sake.
Yep.
Good morning, everybody. The day is finally here. It is opening day of the Maryland archery season. Grant, Cam, and myself are down here on a piece of public ground. Grant and I were actually in here last night doing some scouting, and we ended up seeing 6 different buck and just a handful of doe. Shouldn't say a handful, a pile of doe. Probably saw about maybe 35, 40 deer total down here in some bedding area. Grant and I are in here. Cam is in a different section of this public piece. We're going to see what comes through. It should be an awesome day. It's beautiful out. We're just going to enjoy the day, see what happens, and hopefully we can get some deer on the ground. Seeing that big body deer, I couldn't see its head with my naked eye, but after reviewing the footage, it turned out to be a doe. I thought the body on that thing was big, thought it might have been a buck, but just a big doe. Maybe 10 minutes later, a mountain biker came up through here, and there must have been a doe working the trail that I'm sitting on, because as soon as he crossed right here beside me, she started blowing. Took off the other direction, so it's kind of unfortunate because she probably would have came right in, right down the trail that I'm set up on. But it's about probably 9 o'clock right now. I might sit just a little bit longer, then might go take a nap at midday, and then be back for the evening hunt. But good morning so far. All right, folks, it is around 1:15 right now in the afternoon. I just had one of the wildest encounters I've ever had while deer hunting. This is the first time I've ever done this, but I was doing a bump and dump, kind of sneak through the woods, see what I could see at the midday, and I was walking along a trail with open fields on either side. To my left, I just caught a glimpse of a buck's tines above the grass, walking with the wood line, walking the edge of the wood line. So I dropped back. Dropped my pack and worked the field edge around to where I thought he was, and I got to where I thought he was and I didn't see him, so I backed out and I thought he had went into the woods and I was just going to keep moving, and I get back out on the road, put my pack back on and everything, keep walking up the road, and I look back in there and I see his butt, his face and head, and his neck and the front half of his body was in the weeds or in the fence row, but his butt was sticking out. And where I thought he was actually a little bit further around the corner of a bush. So I dropped back again. I dropped my pack and I snuck up, and I was waiting for the wind to be perfect. It was a marginal wind right at the right moment. It got super windy. It was a strong gust, a sustained gust. And I closed the distance real close, like I really moved. It was a 90 degree in the bush or in the hedgerow, and I was on the side, and he was on the upper side, and I snuck around the point of that bush, and when I got right before I was going to sneak around, I went to full draw, and I just leaned around that bush, the corner of that bush, and all I saw is just his tines sticking up above the grass. He was bedded there. Fortunately, he was facing me, and he caught me. I was at 7 yards. He caught me. He didn't bust. He just kind of, he was looking around, looking at me, and I'm at full draw. I had no shot because I was still kind of shooting through the bush. I could just see his tines through the bush and through the tall grass. And give it like 10 seconds, and he hops up and trots off. He never paused. If he would have paused, it would have been lights out. What's crazy is that buck, if you guys have watched us in years past, 2 years ago, I saw a really, really big 8-point that I passed up at 32 yards. I just didn't have the confidence. You'll have to go back and watch that video. I'll explain it. But I passed him. This is the same buck. He has the, it's just, everything's identical, just bigger. He's got about a 22-inch spread, 10 to 12-inch tines, just a really cool buck. His horns were still kind of that pearly white. He had just lost his velvet, a little hint of red in him from the blood. What a crazy encounter that was. So that was on the north side of a piece of timber. We have a northwest wind, and that buck, when he left, he had the wind on his tail like they normally do. And so we were contemplating hunting up there, but we knew with the wind it would be pushing right to him. So Cam and I swung down around the bottom side to the south side. Last night when I was scouting in here, this field edge, there was about 10 doe. So what we're hoping is that buck joins those does and comes out here in the evening. Cam is about 100 yards to my right, and there's a pinch point right in here, a low spot that they funnel out into, and we're covering both sides of it. So it's about 1:30. We have about 6-7 hours to sit, so we're just going to see what happens. Man, I hope we kill this buck. That thing is an absolute stud of a deer.
Alright guys, so I am out for the evening hunt, and I'm sitting along this field edge, but I'm just hunting off the ground tonight. I really just couldn't get in a tree here in the spot that I needed to be in. So we've done this a lot before on this piece where we have to hunt field edges off the ground. This particular field, actually, I've hunted in the past some here a lot. 2 years ago in the late season, there was a lot of deer using this field, and I hunted down the field farther, but I'm kind of hunting this little gap right here where I'm hoping they walk out. I'm just gonna hide in the weeds here and behind this brush. I kind of have like a wall here in front of me where I should be able to draw when they're behind that stuff and then get a shot at them through this gap right here. This is the field that I scouted last night, and if these does come through this same gap that they did last night, I should be in business. So we'll see what happens. Maybe we can get ourselves an opening day doe, or who knows, maybe even a buck too. We will see what happens, but stay tuned.
Saturday, the second day of the Maryland archery season. I I'm set up on a spot that I actually hunted last year during the rut and saw some really nice buck. That day was just pouring down rain, and I happened to come around a corner and I saw a real nice 10 point, and then I think it was a little smaller of a buck than a couple of doe, but they're in here. And this is the complete opposite side of where we were hunting yesterday and actually midday today. The reason I came up here is I believe this is unpressured right now, and the wind shifted on us. Yesterday was a northwest, today it's a south-southwest. 78, 79 degrees, light south-southwest wind. So we're gonna sit it out and see what happens.
I can see about 180 degrees out here, and farther shot is about 40 yards. I'm a little concerned about deer coming in and making a shot, because at some point today I must have lost my rangefinder. But that stinks. That was a $200 rangefinder I got last year, and I'm pretty sure it's gone. Pretty optimistic about this hunt. Wind's coming straight out of the woods in my face. We know they start coming out around 6 o'clock, 6:30. We'll have to see. I'll have to see what happens. Stay tuned.
Subscribe, follow us on social media, and I'll see you folks.